Is there anything more pleasant than a nice, crisp apple? It's the perfect refresher on a hot summer day. Goes great in pie and certainly won't kill you, right? Normally this is true, but there's one imposter apple out there that brings nothing but poison, and an evil witch has nothing to do with it. What's up with this deadly imposter apple, and where does it rank among the deadliest plants in the world? Most plants are harmless, and we rely on them for a continuation of life on Earth. They're critical for feeding the world, keeping livestock fed, and keeping the air clean. But plants are living things, and some have developed defense systems that mean they should be approached with caution. For those interested in these deadly plants, there's even a poison garden located in the Botanical Gardens in Alnwick, England. As you approach, a sign warns all visitors, warning, these plants can kill. That hasn't stopped it from becoming the garden's most popular attraction, where people can marvel at the world's deadliest plants from a distance. So what are the top 10 plants you should be wary of if you see them in your backyard? Number 10. Jimson weed. If there's a dangerous plant, it would make sense to try to keep it contained in its original habitat. Ever tried to keep your yard free of dandelions? That's easier said than done, and that's what's happening with the North American invasive weed Jimson weed. This weed has all the makings of a regular pest. It smells bad, its roots are deep and hard to pull out, and it can kill you. Well, thankfully that last part isn't a problem with regular weeds. Jimson weed was actually used around the world in traditional medicine, with its leaves containing a natural painkiller, atropine. When smoked in a pipe or used in small amounts, it can be an effective anesthetic or anti-inflammatory. Its hallucinogenic properties also made it popular in religious ceremonies. When used in small, controlled doses, it can be harmless. The problem is, it's very easy to overdose. The plant is loaded with multiple hallucinogenic compounds, and it's common for recreational users with no experience to wind up in the hospital. Those affected can wind up with dangerously high temperatures and heart rates, and highly dilated pupils that can make it painful to be in lighted areas. The effects on the mind can be even worse, with many remembering nothing of the period they were affected. Making it even more dangerous, the toxicity of each plant varies, making each encounter with Jimson weed a deadly game of roulette. Our next deadly plant is a killer in a rather unexpected way. Number 9. Bunya pine. Most of the world's deadliest plants are either loaded with poisonous compounds or have toxic defense systems to prevent themselves from being eaten. But this next plant is a surprising killer completely by accident. The bunya pine is located in Southeast Australia and is the last survivor of a breed of plants that dates back to dinosaur times. It's tall, sturdy, and produces edible nuts that taste a little like chestnuts. The trees themselves pose no threats to humans and are a valuable part of the local ecosystem. So what lands it on this list? The cones. These cones are the size of soccer balls and can weigh up to 40 pounds. Once they land, they become a valuable food source for local birds who can crack them open. But first, they've got to fall from a tree that can get as tall as 90 feet. You probably had a few bumps on the head from when a pine cone lands on your head from a local tree. If a bunya pine cone landed on your head, it'd be game over. You've probably had a close encounter with this next plant on the list as a child. Number 8. Castor oil plant. There are a lot of parts to a plant, and sometimes the danger comes in the smallest part possible. The castor oil plant is a perennial flowering plant that's native to India and the Mediterranean and grown around the world as an ornamental plant. It's a useful plant thanks to its seed, which is the source of castor oil. Any kid who's been fed that oil when they were sick is undoubtedly having terrible flashbacks right now. But the oil has medicinal qualities when processed properly. Unprocessed? Well, that's a very different story. Not only is the plant highly allergenic and dangerous to asthma sufferers, but its raw seeds are highly toxic. The culprit? The compound ricin, which is used in the manufacturing of a deadly chemical weapon. Those who ingest the poison raw can expect to suffer from nausea, digestive issues, a high heart rate, and seizures. The most common cause of poisoning is when people or animals eat the unprocessed seed. To ensure the byproducts are safe, castor oil manufacturers extract the ricin from the seeds before pressing them. The next plant on the list has a long and deadly history of poison. Number 7. Water hemlock. When the famous Greek philosopher Socrates angered the powers that be, he was sentenced to death by drinking the poison hemlock. Good thing that scary ancient poison is a thing of the past, right? Wrong! Water hemlock, the plant it comes from, is a family of similar plants and can be found in temperate regions of North America and Europe. The poison that killed Socrates could be lurking in your backyard. This deadly plant has a high concentration of the neurotoxin cicutoxin in just about every part of it, and it doesn't take much to get exposed. People have been poisoned by rubbing the plant on their skin, blowing into the hollow stem of the flower, or eating small amounts of the leaves. With water hemlock, any amount is too much. Victims will start having seizures not long after consumption, followed by nausea, vomiting, and other common signs of poisoning. The poison then goes to work on the nervous system, causing swelling on the brain and raising the body temperature. The best way to treat someone with hemlock poisoning quickly is by decontaminating their digestive tract with activated charcoal, lessening the effect of the poison so they can recover. But the poison packs a punch, and those who survive hemlock poisoning often need extensive follow-up treatment and monitoring to repair the damage. The next plant doesn't kill most of its victims, but that doesn't mean it's not to be feared. Number 6. Gimpy Stinger. Anyone who's encountered a stinging nettle knows these nasty plants can leave painful marks on you. So naturally, leave it to Australia to take that plant and jack it up to 11. The gimpy stinger has the colorful nickname suicide plant, and it lives up to its name. This plant, native to Australia and Indonesia, covers its leaves with countless hollow needles that embed themselves under the skin and release a painful neurotoxin. Even lightly brushing the plant will leave you with hundreds of these needles in your skin, and the initial pain is just the beginning. It causes agonizing itching that's been known to drive people to irrational, dangerous behavior. There are so many of these needles that it doesn't even need to touch you to do damage. There are reports of people winding up with nosebleeds and rashes just by breathing next to the plant as it sheds needles. Unlike most plants on this list, the effects of the plant don't have a time limit. Once embedded in the skin, they keep releasing toxins for up to a year. This can cause damage to the joints and long-term swelling. People have been known to go into shock or even die from severe poisoning. And don't think old leaves are safe. Dried samples have been found to be just as potent. It's not a surprise that there's a famous story about an Australian soldier who killed himself after using the leaves for toilet paper. It may just be an old army tale, but anyone near the gimpy stinger isn't forgetting it. Next up, this plant is a thing of beauty and of death. Number 5. Oleander. Ah, oleander. This beautiful pink flower is a staple of gardens around the world, and it's been so widely cultivated that no one's sure where it's native to. It's elegant, attractive, and deadly. While it makes a great decoration, anyone who ingests it is in for a very bad time. The good news is it's intensely bitter. This is a plant that doesn't want to be eaten, and it's good at its job. Humans rarely get poisoned by eating oleander, but even handling it for too long can cause skin and eye inflammation. So who is oleander most dangerous to? Our furry friends. This plant is a common culprit in pet poisonings, with dogs being especially sensitive. Ingesting too much of the compounds in oleander can affect the gastrointestinal tract, the heart, and even the nervous system. The first signs will usually be nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, but more severe poisonings can cause irregular heart rates and poor circulation. To save a poisoning victim, the best way is to induce vomiting as quickly as possible. Oleander isn't responsible for most poisonings on the list thanks to its foul taste, but it has a reputation as a plant associated with suicides. Its biggest threat is just how common it is and how easy it is to mistake for other plants. There have been poisonings from people using oleander branches for cooking sticks or for fires. That hasn't stopped it from being planted all around the world. It helps to be pretty. How far would you go for some beautiful jewelry? Those who work with this next plant are ready to tempt death. Number 4. Rosary pea. In fact, some of the prettiest plants in the world are also the deadliest. The rosary pea, a small bean native to Asia and Australia, has a striking red color that also serves as a warning, because this little berry packs a big poison punch. Its toxin works very similarly to ricin, but is more than twice as toxic. It's very easy to ingest a fatal dose of this poison. But the good news is that the poison is contained inside the hard seeds. That means that people who eat a berry but don't crack the seed may be fine. Despite its deadly nature, the rosary pea is actually used widely in its geographic area. It's used in traditional medicine, with the seed being boiled to eliminate the poison. Rumored to boost hair growth, it's sometimes incorporated into Indian hair products. Because its seeds are identical, it can be used as a unit of measure. But its most popular use may be in jewelry due to its bright color. This use may actually be the most dangerous. How can making jewelry be deadly? Because the seeds need to be pierced to string them for jewelry. there's always the risk of someone piercing the seed and releasing the poison, only to then stick themselves with the needle. Has any unfortunate jewelry maker met their end on a tainted needle? No one's sure, but rumors persist about the dangers. This next plant could be in your backyard, but don't try to pull it like a weed. Number 3. Giant hogweed. Many of these deadly plants are unassuming and can't easily hide in your yard. The giant hogweed, though, is going to make itself known. This invasive weed is tall, quick to spread, and very hard to remove. It started out in the Caucasus region and then was brought to Britain because of its impressive appearance. It spread like wildfire from there and is now all over Europe and the United States, and where it goes, pain follows. Giant hogweed has a powerful defense system in its sap, causing a painful skin condition that results in extreme sensitivity to light. Even normal exposure to the sun can cause a painful blister, burns, and permanent scarring. Making it even more dangerous, giant hogweed looks like the common garden plant Queen Anne's lace and appears to be harmless, but even casual contact can result in burns lasting days. It's unlikely to cause permanent damage unless the sap gets near the eyes. This plant is such a common public health hazard that it's been classified as a noxious weed that should be removed when found. Many people hire professionals to get rid of giant hogweed plants, but if you're planning to do battle with this menacing weed, it's recommended you wear goggles and gloves for maximum protection. You're probably familiar with this next plant, but don't be fooled by its delicious appearance. Number 2. Deadly nightshade. Who doesn't like tomatoes and eggplant, right? These popular dinner table staples have an unwelcome relative, just like that cousin who always wants to borrow money. Except that deadly nightshade is bringing death, not an awkward family dinner. Spreading across Europe, North Africa, and Western Asia, it's since spread to the US, where it can be found just about everywhere. Also known as belladonna, its berries are so toxic it's famous for a poison dating back to ancient Rome. A standard-looking flowering shrub, it's known for a distinct black berry, which looks a little like oval blueberries. Making them even more dangerous, these berries are sweet and designed to be eaten by animals. They'll ingest the seeds whole and spread them in their droppings, leaving them intact and safe. The danger comes when they're eaten by a human, who would be more likely to chew and unleash the toxins hidden in the seeds. Deadly nightshade is one of the most toxic plants in the world, and all parts of the plant are loaded with a host of toxins that can cause conditions including nervous system damage and hallucinations. Despite this, it's used in cosmetics, dietary supplements, and alternative medicines, and is also popular as a hallucinogenic drug for those willing to take the risk. So, what's the tree that overshadows all of these deadly plants? Get ready to meet the death apple. Number 1. The death apple. Deadly nightshade may be sweet and inviting, but it doesn't work as hard to fool you as the final plant on this list. The death apple, or manchineel, looks almost exactly like an apple tree from the leaves to the fruit. It's also one of the most toxic trees in the world, with every part of the plant filled with a milky toxic sap that can cause extreme skin ailments. Not only can touching the leaves or fruit cause serious skin irritation or blisters, but the poison is so strong that you don't need to be touching it. If the tree burns, the smoke is toxic enough to cause eye damage. If someone takes refuge under the tree while it's raining, the water will mix with the sap and burn them. So what would happen if someone ate it? It might be pretty hard to find out, given that soon after taking the first bite, that unlucky person would be experiencing extreme burning and blistering on the inside of their mouth and throat. No one's gotten far enough to swallow it, but if the fruit got into the digestive tract, it would likely be fatal. Despite this, the tree is still used as a source of wood after being carefully cut and dried to remove the sap. Mostly found in the Caribbean and Mexico and Central and South America, it's made inroads into the United States and Florida. You'd think they'd remove the death apple as soon as they found it, right? Well, not quite. It's classified as an endangered species. I'd look carefully before making your next apple pie. For more on how humanity and plants interact, check out How Long Can You Survive If All the Plants in the World Die? Or check out this other video instead.